pagkatapos ng introduction. Okay na. Hello. Parang mananakit si Day. Okay, so good morning. So it's been a privilege to speak in front of you. So talagang medyo nakakaba, but I know that God will help us to teach us and to understand His word. This morning my daughter talked to me. She said, "Tatay, I don't understand when you talk in front, you speak in English." Kaya daw hindi sila nakikinig kasi nagtatagalog daw ako. This time I will try how you listen. Okay, let's open our Bible in the book of 1 John. So this is the book that we're going to study. So last time we studied the book of 1 John chapter 1, and this time let's go to 1 John chapter number 2, and let's read from verse number 1 to 6. Let's all stand up as we read this. Let's read this responsibly. 1 John chapter 2, verse 1 to 6. Okay, "My little children, these things write I unto you, that ye sin not. And if any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous." "And hereby we know that we know him if we keep his commandments. But whoso keepeth his word, in him verily is the love of God perfected. Hereby we know we that we are in him." Together. "He that saith he abideth in me, he so to walk even as he walked." Let's come to the Lord in prayer. Our Father in heaven, Lord, thank you once again for giving us this time to study your word. I pray, Father, that you will guide us. Let the Holy Spirit teach every one of us. I pray, Lord, that you will guide my lips. Help me, Lord, to deliver this message. As I study this, I saw the truth from thy word. Help your people to understand and give each every one of us a receptive heart to understand your word. I pray, Father, that in everything we do, may give glory to your name. And I pray that bless this message, Almighty God. Thank you so much, Lord, for everything. Forgive us from all our sins. All these things I ask and pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Okay, so the theme of this epistle of John, if you're going to read that, is about fellowship. Last time we studied that the source of the fellowship. It was mentioned here in chapter 1 that the source of our fellowship is the Lord Jesus Christ. In order to have fellowship with the Father and with the brethren, sabi ni John dito, for so that which was from the beginning, in verse number 2, "For the life was manifested, and we have seen it, and bear witness, and shew unto you that eternal life which was with the Father, and was manifested unto us." And verse 3, "That which we have seen and heard declare we unto you, that ye also may have fellowship with us," fellowship with the brethren, "and truly our fellowship is with the Father, and with his Son, Jesus Christ." So, Apostle John is telling us that we can have fellowship with the Father. This fellowship is not just only merely just yung simply talking or getting together, but this is a close relationship. We have a personal relationship with the Lord, and we can do that because of the Lord Jesus Christ. And Apostle John is inviting us to have fellowship with him, and he stated us here in this chapter, in chapter number 1. And also he's inviting us to have fellowship, the invitation of fellowship here in I didn't put the verse, and the purpose of the fellowship is that your joy may be full, para makumpleto yung ating kaligayahan. It's, I know those who experience real salvation experience the real joy in their life. And we know the difference between happiness and joy. Happiness depends on the happening. That's why it came from happiness, happening. But joy, it depends on the your inside, in the intestine, ang sasabihin ko. Sa inside, sa kalooban. Ayan po ang real joy. At only Jesus Christ can give the real joy. And we know that. Hindi natin makikita yan. We cannot find real joy in this world, but only through Jesus Christ. And also, we can see that there are some people who are assuming that they have fellowship. And we study that there are people nowadays, actually, I think all of the churches, there is some Christian that they are telling they are saved, but they are not. That's why this epistle is telling us to check our situation, our standing in the sight of God. Are we really saved or not? Maybe we are assuming that we are with fellowship with the Father and with the brethren, but deep in our heart we know that we don't belong. Ayan nga yung sinabi ni Kay kagabi, sabi niya binigyan daw siya ng ano ba yung mug? Sheep clothing. World in sheep clothing. Ayun daw siya. Ngayon lang nila nahalata. Hindi naman. Talagang nakita ko ang pagbabago ng buhay ni Kay. So, kita ka na yan. So, there are people who are assuming that they belong to the fellowship, but they are not. And then, and we can see also here in chapter 1, the requirements of fellowship. Ano yung mga requirements? Ayan po yung kailangan. Meron kang personal relationship with God. You know the Lord Jesus Christ, and you live for Jesus. Now here, in chapter number 2, John wrote this letter to answer the question many Christians are asking. Am I really a Christian? I don't know if you ask that once in your, when you are sa panahon na kay Kristiyano. Totoo nga ba talaga akong Kristiyano? Why I am doing this? Why I am not? Why I didn't feel this? Sabi nga nila, I heard some testimony when they accepted the Lord Jesus Christ. They feel the something come inside their life. Parang may power na pumasok. Ewan ko sa inyo kung ganun ang na-experience yun when you received the Lord Jesus Christ, when you repented of your sin and believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. Did you feel that there is a power or there's a joy? Siguro iba, that's why our salvation is not dependent on our feeling. It's not dependent on the feeling. It is dependent on the truth. Whatever the Bible says, we need to ayun dapat yung ating sundin, hindi yung ating mga feeling. And then also we can see here, we can answer the question, how do I know that I'm really saved? Did we ask that? Am I really a saved person? How do I know that I have a right relationship with God? Do I have a right relationship with God? If not, how can I have a right relationship with God? And how do I know that I have a right fellowship with God and with brethren? So here in 1 John, we can see, 1 John chapter number 2, we can see it here about this question. And this epistle, 1 John chapter 1, is challenging us to walk in the light, to have fellowship with God and the brethren. It's in verse 5 and 7, chapter number 1. Our first step in walking in the light is to walk away from sin. In order to walk in the light, we need to walk away from sin. And walking in the light must begin by walking away from sin. This means by confessing our sins. That's why in 1 John 1, 9 says that it says here, if we confess our sins, He is faithful and just to forgive us and to cleanse us from all our unrighteousness, because we as a human being, we always are prone to sin. Madadaanan niya natin. Now here in chapter number 2, we can see here another topic about fellowship. Na here in verse number 1, sabi rito, "My little children, these things write I unto you, that ye sin not. And if any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous." So makikita natin dito, si John, wala na may binanggit ba sa Bible na may asawa si John, diba? John the Beloved? Ewan ko may nabasa kayo. Pero dito may sinabi, "My little children," may mga anak siya. At yung mga anak niya, maliliit pa. So, isang patunay na meron siya. Malalalim na ba? Hindi, pag ganyan ka mag-interpret ng Bible, sabi, "Oh, may anak si John, oh, yun, oh, maliliit pa nga yung anak niya." Hindi kayo kailan. "My little." So, it means only that he's talking about, he's addressing this epistle to the church. He's a children in faith, and we know that na yung mga na-win niya sa Panginoon, na dala niya, at yung kanya mga, because he was an apostle, and he has the authority as a father in faith. So he says here, "My little children, these things write I unto you, that ye sin not. And if any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous." Now we can see here, number 1, the hindrance of fellowship. What is the hindrance of fellowship, fellowshipping with God and with the brethren? That is sin. I sabi, that "these things write I unto you." Sabi ni John, "I write these things unto you," all this from chapter number 1, "I wrote this so that ye sin not." So the purpose of this letter is that ye sin not. How can we sin not number 1? By forsaking sin. We need to forsake sin. But it's really hard to do that. That's why we need to rely on the power of the Holy Spirit. If we just keep on relying on ourselves, we cannot do that. Kaya nga nagawa yung kantang "Gusto kong bumait pero di ko magawa," di ba? Sabi nga ni Paul in sa Romans, I don't know, I forget the chapter and verse, yung "Gusto kong maging gano'n, pero ang nagagawa ko ganito," di ba? Ang hirap i-memorize nun. Memorize lang, mahirap na, gawin pa. Di ba? Parang, "I do not, I do this, sa mga do-do. Mahirap. Kasi we are still in the flesh. But at the last part of that chapter, "But thank God the Lord is, "For that which I do, I allow not. For what I would, that do I not. But what I hate, that do I. If then I do that which I would not, I consent unto the law that it's good." And then 17, "Now then it is more I that do it, but sin that dwelleth in me." So ayan ang sinasabi ni Paul, na may mga bagay na gusto akong gawin pero nahihirapan akong gawin. May kusang lumalabas sa atin. Unless, now, if we are relying on the Holy Spirit, we cannot become victorious. But thank God, because in Jesus Christ we are victorious already. But sometimes we are living as a defeated Christian. But we need to claim that we have the power to overcome sin. So that is the hindrance of fellowship. The purpose of this letter is to warning us that ye sin not. Huwag tayong magkasala. Ito na, di ba, I remember when Pastor teach this about the is it possible that a Christian will not commit sin? Yan, naalaman natin. Posibleng mangyari na hindi tayo magkasala. Kasi sinabi nga rito, huwag kayong magkasala. Pero, but it was in verse chapter number 1, verse 8, sabi sa, "If we say that we have no sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us." So it means only that we, as a human being, we will commit sin. Because we are still in our flesh. We are not yet in glorified body. So that's the purpose of the letter, by we that ye sin not. And then the condition of this letter, It says here, there's a condition, but if any man sin. So my condition, kasi we know that we will commit sin. And John said, and if any man sin. So that is a condition, we cannot be sinless in this life. But ayun nga, lagi natin na rin, we cannot be sinless, but we can sin less. Yung wala na yung desire mo sa kasalanan. I don't know if you still have the appetite in gambling. Parang masaya ka pa kapag ikaw ay nagsusugal, nananalo, di ba? Masaya ka pa kapag ikaw ay nakakapandaya. Di ba minsan na magta-timing tayo sa school. Ay, alis, hindi ako nahalata. Parang tuwan-tuwa pa tayo minsan eh. Hindi man tayo makonsensya. Ako na, nagkasala na naman ako. Di ba? I don't know what you feel about that. If you are still enjoying in sin, that is a big question mark. Because Apostle John says here, that ye sin not, and if any man sin, so that's a condition, we cannot be sinless. Sabi ni John, if any man sin, at siguradong magkakasala tayo, we have, this is the provision of the letter, we have an advocate with the Father. So ito po yung magandang balita na although as a Christian, as a believer, we can commit sin, but thank God that we have an advocate. Jesus is our advocate. Ano yung advocate sa Tagalog? Abokado. Malalalim yan, maganyan. Nabulol lang yan, kaya naging abogado eh. Abokado talaga yan. Jesus Christ is our advocate. He stands alongside us in order to help in any way possible. This picture a friend who offers comfort and help to one who is troubled or distressed. It pictures a commander called upon to encourage and equip a discouraged troop. It also pictures a lawyer who pleads our case before the judge. Jesus is each of those of us. When we sin and fail in the journey, we have an advocate who stands with us and for us. Jesus Christ is telling us, telling the Father that our sin are already paid. It doesn't mean that He is not condoning sin. It doesn't mean that when we commit sin, Jesus Christ says, okay lang yung magkasala, bayad na yan eh. Hindi po ganun. Kaya nga sinasabihan tayo, may mga nagsasabing Christians, the one save, always save. It's just a license. They said it's your license to commit sin. Dahil parang okay na lang sa atin magkasala. Hindi po okay ang magkasala. You know the pain of committing sin. I don't know if you still feel the pain when you commit sin. Minsan pag nagsisinungaling tayo, parang normal na lang, di ba? When was the last time when you commit, when you tell a lie, and then you feel the pain of lying? Kasi minsan kasi iniisip natin yung maliliit na kasinungalingan lang, no? Sabihin, Brad, may pera ka ba dyan? Wala. Walang-wala ako. Pero labas-labas. Pwede mo na sabihin, may pera ako pero hindi kita pa utangin. Hindi kasi nagtatrabaho eh, di ba? Pwede mo na sabihin yun eh, ba't kailangan pa natin magsinungaling? Di ba? Kaya, ayun lang. So, we have an advocate. Meron po tayong abogado. At hindi, not only that. So, a human defense lawyer argues for the innocence of his client. Ito yun sa system of the world. But our advocate, Jesus Christ, admits our guilt. He says that this man or this woman is guilty. But, and then he enters his plea on our behalf as the one who was made an atoning sacrifice for our sinful guilt. What a blessing it is that we have an advocate with the Father, and that is Jesus Christ, who knew no sin. He didn't commit any sin. He is a righteous person. But he get our sin. He paid our sin. So that is the number one, the hindrance of fellowship. It is the sin. But thank God, even though we commit sin, We have an advocate with the Father. We can confess our sins. That was written here in 1 John 1:9. If we confess our sins, He is faithful and just to forgive us and to cleanse us from all our unrighteousness. Now let's go to verse number 2. And number 2, it says here, and He is the propitiation for our sins, and not for ours only, but also for the sins of the whole world. So I remember Preacher Jong posted this. Pinapakita doon na hindi lang ang Panginoon talaga ay binayaran niya ang kasalanan ng buong mundo. Hindi lang kasi sa mga iba, ano, sa mga hyper-Calvinist, talagang ang binayaran lang daw ng Panginoon ay ang mga elect. Kung titingnan natin, may ano naman sila, pero parang mahirap doon natin ilagay yung ating paniniwala. Pag sinabi ng Panginoon, whosoever, all, if any man, lahat po yun. At hindi na atin alam kung sino yun. Kaya we need to do. And John says, He is the propitiation. Number 2, the restoration of fellowship. How can we restore that fellowship? And He Himself is the propitiation of our sins. This means that Jesus is the one who atones for and takes away our sins. And not only our sins, but also the sins of the whole world. Propitiation here. Jesus is our propitiation. This means He is our sacrifice, our covering, the payment and appeasement for sin, fully satisfying the righteous demands of the Father. Na satisfy niya yung righteousness ng Panginoon dahil sa ginawa ng Panginoon. Yung sa vocabulary of salvation, this is what we call the propitiation. Ayun. So parang appease yung yung na-satisfy. Diba? I know that most all of us here, when we still young, we fight with other person. If somebody hit us, and then we need to revenge. Anong maisip eh? Kung paano, at pag may gumanti sa atin, para bang, okay na. Na-appease na ako. Satisfied na ako sa ginawa mo. Naalala ko nung ako'y maliit. I remember when I was, I think, grade 2, a grade 3, in Buendia, we are living in squatter area. I always fight with my friend. Talagang suntukan kami. Eh, may time na talagang nahawakan ako, nasuntok ako sa mukha 2 beses. Nahawakan kasi, tapos binitawan ako. Tumakbo yung ano, ako'y galit, naghinabol ko siya sa bahay nila. Pumasok siya at nakita ko may kapatid siyang maliit. Ayun ang binanatan ko. Pag naisip ko yun, pambiran sa mga akong tao. At yung batang maliit na yun, ang matindi, lumpo pa. Ewan ko ba't nagawa ko yun. Dahil sa galit, kasi hinawakan ako eh, tapos sinuntok ako dalawa sa mukha. Siyempre, yung galit mo, talagang hinabol ko siya. Eh, takbo siya sa loob ng bahay. Eh, nakita yung bata, nakaganon lang. Batu ko. Ay, yarin, ilusob ako ng nanay. Buti hindi masyadong malakas. Parang ganun po yung appeasement, pero maling ano yun eh. Yung maling paraan. Yung parang nasatisfy yung ano mo, yung galit. Ang Diyos galit sa kasalanan. But because of Jesus Christ, He is our propitiation. No, nasatisfy ng Panginoong Jesus yung righteous anger ng Panginoon dahil sa kasalanan. So, ayan po ang to restore the fellowship. Propitiation has the idea of presenting a gift to the gods so as to turn away the displeasure of the gods. But in Christian idea, the propitiation, God Himself presents Himself in Jesus Christ as that which will turn away His righteous wrath against our sin. Ang Diyos galit sa kasalanan, pero mismo ang Diyos ang gumawa ng paraan para yung righteous wrath niya ay mapunan. Diba? Yung galit niya ay na, hindi naman yung galit niya na appease dahil sa ginawa ng Panginoon sa atin. And it says here, and not for ours only, but also for the whole world. Though Jesus made His propitiation for the whole world, yet the whole world is not saved and in fellowship with God. This because atonement does not equal forgiveness. The atoning sacrifice of Jesus Christ is not equal to forgiveness. It doesn't mean that Jesus was he died on the cross. It doesn't mean that everybody is forgiven. Those who will repent of sin, those who will accept the Lord Jesus Christ and believe in his in what he did, will be saved. Ayun po ang sinasabi rin. Kaya we can see here that we can check that if we really, we can answer is, am I really a Christian? If we did this, for sure, you are a true Christian. And then let's go to number 3. Verse 3. And hereby we do know that we know him if we keep his commandments. Number 3, the fruit of the fellowship. What's the fruit of fellowship? We can know him. Makikilala natin ang Panginoon. Sabi, and hereby we do know that we know him. The evidence of someone knowing God and fellowship with him is that they keep his commandments. A simple, loving obedience is a natural result of fellowship with God. To know God is not only mean that you know him in mind, intellectually. Because there are many people saying that, oh, I know God. I know that there is God. Especially those who are Catholic. Pag tanongin mo, kilala mo, oh, I know that there are three person in one God. And they know that. But that's not enough. It doesn't mean that you know him personally. To know God is not only mean that you know him in mind, but you know him by heart and love him and with personal relationship with him. Do you have a personal relationship with God? Many, I know each every one of us here know each other. But I don't know more on Brother John compared to Sister Jalil. She knows more her husband than me. Because they have a relationship. It's just like with our father. We can say we know God, but we don't have relationship and we don't really know him. Sabi nga ng kanta, Lord, I want to know you more. Deep within my soul, I want to know you. Lord, I want to know you more. Diba? Ayan yung kanta. Ang pahaba yan eh. So we can know him. This is the fruit of the fellowship. We can know the Father. Napaka-privilege po natin na meron tayong paraan na makikilala natin ang Panginoon. Dahil God is a parang inano niya yung kanyang sarili, na ino-offer niya ang kanyang sarili na kilalanin niyo ako. But only us yung nagre-resist, na talagang ayaw nating kilalanin ng Panginoon. And hereby we do know that we know him. We can know that we are a Christian. It says here, and hereby we don't know, we do know, malalaman natin. This is an assurance of salvation. A real Christian takes time and talk to God. Do we have time for God? Do we have time to talk with God? Do we have time that God will talk to us? How is our prayer life? Our study? Iba yung kasi nagbabasa lang, di ba? Basa, madali lang magbasa. Pero iba yung nag-aaral tayo. It is a challenge for us. And this is what we are saying here in this pulpit, that we need to study the Word of God. Each, every one of us, we need to, dapat nga, lahat tayo kung ano yung nalalaman ng ating pastor, kung ano ang abet, kailangan malaman din natin lahat. Ay nga, sabi ng ating pastor, diba? Gusto niya, mas mahigitan pa nga natin siya sa kaalaman, at mag-share tayo. Hindi yung nag-aantay lang tayo kung ano, kasi dun tayo nasanay, diba? Tapos makakarinig ka pa ng pastor na, kung hindi ko ipapaliwanag sa inyo, wala kayong maiintindihan. Diba? Kaya ikaw talaga, makikinig ka na lang. Hindi ka na, kasi babasahin mo. Parang walang pinagkaiba sa mga iglesia ni Kristo eh. Di ba iglesia ni Kristo, hindi sila pinagbabasa ng Bible? Huwag kayong magbasa, hindi nyo maiintindihan yan. Yung ministro lang, ipapaliwanag sa inyo. Ganun din, may mga Baptist na rin ganun. Na ang pastor lang ang nakakaintindi, ang mga miyembro, hindi. So, nakakalungkot po. But here, we can know him. Ayan ang sinasabi ni John, we can know him, and hereby we do know that we know him. Paano if we keep His commandments? How can I know that I'm a Christian here if you keep His commandments? So we need to test our character. Remember, I don't know if you see the bracelet, yung WWJD. Ano ba yan? Who wants Jack Daniels? I don't know. What would Jesus do? Sabi siya, who wants Jack Daniels? Ano yung Jack Daniels? Ano ba yun? Cedric Aya. Ay, pambira. Teacher Marlin. So ano ba yun? What would Jesus do? Ano ba yung gagawin ng Panginoon? Live how we keep His commandments. Live the way He wants you to live. To keep His commandment means obedience to God's word and command and His commandments. In John chapter 14, verse 15, sabi ng Panginoong Jesus, if ye love me, keep my commandments. It is a show that we really love God if we keep His commandments. It's easy to say that we love God. Diba? Madaling sabihin na mahal mo ang isang tao, alam mo kapatid, mahal kita. Pero hindi man nakikita sa atin ang pagmamahal. Hindi man natin pinanalangin, di ba? I don't know if you are praying for each other. Na meron po ba kayong, minsan mas maganda ilista natin yung binigay ni Ate Bel, nandun lahat ng mga member, no? Ipanalangin natin ng bawat isa. Mas maganda nga kung may, meron kang hinanakit sa isang kapatiran, mas maganda ipanalangin mo at habang pinapanalangin mo, nawawala yung galit, di ba? Napapalitan ng pagmamahal. Sabi ng Panginoong Jesus, if you really love me, you must keep my commandments. His commandments is His words. So we need to check our character. And then, ayan po, makikita po natin yan. Ayan ang fruit of fellowship. We can know the Father. And then number four, the test of the fellowship. Verse number four, it says here, he that saith, I know him, and keepeth not his commandments, is a liar, and the truth is not in him. The test of the fellowship is keepeth not his commandment. Those who keep not his commandment is a liar. The liar, those who say they know him and don't keep his commandments. Diba? Dito po nanggaling yung kasabihang action speak louder than drama. Mas malakas yung action kaysa sa drama. Now, actions speak louder than words. Iba yung pinakikita, sinasabi mo sa pinakikita mo. Diba? You say that you love Him. I know God. But you know Him only in mind, not in heart. John says, you are a liar. I don't know, let's evaluate ourselves. Am I like this person? Diba, mas medyo mabigat na salita to, you are a liar. You are saying that you know him and keepeth not his commandments. You are a liar. There's no fruit. There's no evidence of change. Walang pagbabago. The things I used to do, I do it more and more. Diba? Yung kantang ganyan, sabi ni Brother John. Naalala ko sa kinakanta lagi sa Bible study. There's a Gretchen since I was saved. There's a Gretchen since... Si Gretchen, yung Gretchen Barreto. Hindi niya alam. Nakuha ni Brother Wilson. There's a great change since I was saved. Is there really a great change? Not Gretchen. Kasi Bisaya yung kumakanta ko ng Gretchen. There's a Gretchen since... Para sa yung laro ng Dell or no Dells? pili na, Dell or no Dells? Sana no Dells yung sinisibaw yun na. No Dells. No Dells. No deal. Sabi nga, no Dells. Yun din yun, same. There is no evidence of change. There's no desire about things that are related to God. We are a liar if we don't have this. Para bang corny yung dating sa atin pag nag-uusap tayo ng mga spiritual na bagay? May nakasalamuhan na kayong Kristiyano ganun? Pambira, kagaling lang natin church. Ayan na naman pag-uusapan natin. Iba naman, Brad. Iba naman. Pambira naman. Ano ka ba? Lalagpas ka sa langit niyan. Di ba, mas maganda na lumagpas kesa yung hindi ka umabot. Di ba? Kantay, muntik nang mabot ang langit. Sino ba yung kamanta nun? Sergey Jalil, kilala yun eh. Si Gretchen. So, mas maganda na yung... Ewan ko, pag nakakarinig ako ng ganun, kasi kaibang tao to. Ayaw ko lang sabihin kung sino eh. Hindi, wala rito, wala rito. Hindi, ewan ko kung nakakita na kayong ganun. Minsan, sa pag na-attend kayo ng conference, di ba, pag pastor's conference, yung unang attend ko, talagang expected mong spiritual yung mga, abay, doon ko nakakita yung mga bastos na kwento eh. So, pambira ito mga pastor na ito. Sabi ko, pambira. Ang hirap makinig. Di ba? Sabi, ay, uusap na naman tayo, kaka-preach-preach lang eh. Iba naman, di ba? Iba naman, eh, change topic. Nakakairita yung kwentong ganyan. Di ba? Dapat nire-repeat yung kung ikaw ganon, kung although hindi mo man sinasabi pero nasa isip mo naman to, ay na naman mga verse na naman ng Bible, wala na bang ibang sasabihin tong tao na to? I-check mo sarili mo, kapatid. Wala kang pagmamahal sa salita ng Panginoon. Hindi ka ba nag-i-enjoy po ba tayo na mag-usap ng patungkol sa salita? Nag-i-enjoy nga tayo, mga kwento-kwentuhan lang eh. Mas dapat mag-enjoy tayo na nagkwekwentuhan tungkol sa salita. Na minsan na nabe-bless kami kapag pagtas namin mag-basketball at nagkwekwentuhan kami tungkol sa gawain sa salita ng Panginoon, di ba? Hindi lang akala nyo lang kasi puro basketball kami. Nag-ano kami, nag-sharing kami. Minsan. So ganun po. Do we have the desire? If we say we know Him and keep it na His commandments, we are a liar. And the truth is not in Him. Wala ang katotohanan sa atin. Ayan po ang matetest natin kung talagang may fellowship tayo sa Panginoon. And then number 5, the mark of the true fellowship, verse 5 and verse 6. But whoso keepeth His word, in him verily is the love of God perfected. Hereby know we that we are in Him. Those who keep His word, this is the mark of the true fellowship. John also makes the link between our obedience and our love for God. A perfected, the idea is mature. It means mature. It doesn't mean that we don't have sin. Yung perfect dito is yung we are matured. Love for God will show itself in obedience. And the presence of this obedience and love gives us assurance that we are in Jesus Christ. By this we know we are in Him. Mark it. When one becomes a Christian, there is a change in their relationship with sin. May pagbabago. Yung pakikitungo mo sa kasalanan. Sin is not eliminated in the believer until he comes to glory. Hindi maalis sa atin yan. But their relationship to sin is changed when they truly become a Christian. This will answer the question, am I really a Christian? How is your relationship to sin? Are you still enjoying it? Are you still happy to do it? Are you really intentionally do the thing? Or you are grieving? Sabi nga, a Christian no longer loves sin as he once did. Before we love sin, I love to go to disco houses, to drink beer, to smoke, to go to disco bar. But because of the Lord Jesus Christ, it changed my relationship with sin. I don't have any appetite in those things. A Christian no longer brags about their sin as he once did. Di ba ito minsan, di ba payabangan pa tayo sa, ay, pambihira. Ako, 6 naging girlfriend ko, pinahirapan ko sila lahat. Di ba? Parang masayang-masaya ka pa sa ano. Ay, ako, nakapandaya ako. Hindi ako nagbayad sa jeep. Di ba? Kunya na, nagtulog-tulugan ako. May kwekwento. Minsan, nakikwento ko rin yun. Ano ako eh. Sabi ko,
kinikwento sa mga kaibigan ko, alam nyo, ang sikreto para hindi kayo makabayad sa jeep, yung abot ka lang ng abot. Ama, bayad oh. Bayad oh. Ipapakita. Lalakasan mo lang boses mo. Ipagyayabang mo pa yun, di ba? Diba? Tinong, nakalusot ako. Are we still doing that? Are we still bragging about the sin that we commit? And then a Christian no longer plans to sin as he once did. Before, we are planning to do sin, but now, we don't plan it anymore. A Christian never fully enjoys sin as he once did. Before, we are enjoying sin, but now, a little bit only. Hindi na dapat. Hindi na dapat tayo nag-i-enjoy sa kasalanan. Pero minsan unaware tayo, kaya nga dapat we need to be extra careful na hindi natin alam kasi yung mga bagay na parang hindi naman kasalanan, pag-iisipin natin, kasalanan pala. Malalaman mo naman kasalanan kapag nag-iba pakiramdam mo, parang kakaiba yung ginawa ko. You need to evaluate. Ayun nga sinabi ni Brother Jong na sa umpisa pa lang, isipin mo na mag-decide ka na, planuhin mo na hindi mo na gagawin para pag dumating, hindi ka na magplano. Alam mo na ang gagawin mo. So, a Christian never fully enjoy his sin as he once did. And a Christian no longer is comfortable in habitual sin as he once did. Mayroon tayong mga habitual sin, no? But because we say that we know him, we have the mark of the true fellowship, we are not enjoying those things. So that's what we can see here in verse number 5. Whoso keepeth his word in him, verily is the love of God perfected. Hereby know that we are in him. Malalaman natin na tayo'y sa Diyos kung ating ginagawa ang mga bagay na yun. And not only those who keep his word, but those who walked in his word. Verse 6, he that saith he abideth in him ought himself also to walk even as he walked. Lakaran natin kung ano yung nilakaran ng Panginoon. When you walk with Jesus means action and devotion. How we walked on earth, walked in truth, walked in light, walked in love, love what he loves and hate what he hates. That's what it means walking with Jesus. Remember the song, walking with Jesus, walking every day, walking all the way of our life. We need to walk with the Lord Jesus Christ. The thought is brought around to a full circle. When we are abiding in Jesus, we will walk just as He walked. Live lives of obedience and love. When we want to walk just as He walked, we need to begin by abiding in Him. We need to abide. Jesus Christ says, abide in me and I in you. If any man will not abide in me, he will not bear fruit. We need to always abide in the Lord Jesus Christ. So to walk just as He walked, we aren't called to imitate the way Jesus walked on water. Hindi yung sabihing lumakad ka sa tubig. Hindi natin magagawa yon. But His everyday walk with God the Father, the spiritual power evident in the life of Jesus flowed from a faithful, regular, disciplined life of fellowship and obedience. The point here is that the one who knows God will increasingly lead a righteous life. For God is righteous. We can evaluate ourselves. Am I really living a righteous life? Because it will answer that are we really a true Christian? It does not mean that he will be sinless. John has already shown that anyone who claims this is lying. If you say that you cannot sin, you are also a liar. Hindi mo pwede sabihin, I attained the righteous. Di ba may nagsabing ganon? Sino ba yun? Parang hindi na siya nagkakasala. Yung sabihin niya pala yun, nagkasala na siya. Ayan sabi ni John dito eh. If you say you don't have sin, you are a liar. Imposible eh. Kasi wala ka pa tayo sa ating righteous body. He is lying. It simply means that he will be moving in a direction marked out by the righteousness of God. If he does not do this, if he is not increasingly dissatisfied with and distressed by sin, he is not God's child. So if we are not, we don't feel anything about sin, we are enjoying it, for sure we are not of God. Hindi po tayo sa Diyos. So ito po ay warning po sa atin. Kasi banda dito, bandang sa huling chapter, lalo pang in-expose ni John yung mga talagang hindi Kristiyano. Una, inilay down niya muna kung paano tayo magiging Kristiyano, paano tayo magkaroon ng fellowship. At kapag may fellowship na tayo, chine-check niya rin kung talagang totoo yung fellowship na sinasabi natin. Are we really a true Christian? Are we really a true saved person? Yung nga sinasabi ni Pastor Jesse, di ba? May pag tinatanong niya yung, parang na-o-offend sila pag tinanong, paano ka naligtas? Oh, ba't mo ko tatanong paano naligtas? Wala ka bang tiwala na naligtas ako? Di ba? Pero may mga taong katanong-tanong, pwede mong tanongin, Kristiyano ka ba talaga? Di ba? Ano kaya masasabi sa atin ng tao? Diba? Ewan ko kung natanong na po kayo, are you a Christian? Kung may nagtanong na sa inyo yan, anong sasabihin nyo? Yes, I'm a Christian. I'm not a Muslim. Di ba? Baka ganun sabihin natin. But we know what is really a Christian is. And it was here. Actually, Christian is a negative connotation to the follower of Jesus Christ before. But it means that if you say that you are a Christian, you really ready to die for the Lord Jesus Christ. Understand? Now, the question for us is, how is our fellowship with God and the brethren? Kumusta po yung fellowship natin sa Panginoon at sa kapatiran? Are we still enjoying the fellowship? Or we are... Kasi nga, kung hindi ka nag-i-enjoy, ako, enjoy ko i-fellowship ang Panginoon. Pero ang kapatiran, wala, hindi ko ma-enjoy yung fellowship. Ayun mo, sinabi rin ni John dito, na sinasabi mong mahal mo ang Panginoon, pero yung kapatid mo, hindi mo mamahal. Sinungaling ka, kapatid. Wala sa iyo ang katotohanan. Hindi nga natin ma-enjoy na tayo nagkikita-kita, lalo pa yung Panginoon na hindi natin makita. Ay, niloloko mo lang sarili mo. Kailangan ma-enjoy muna natin ang bawat isa. At doon makikita natin, masasabi nga ni John dito sa kanyang epistle, may papakita na talagang mahal mo ang Panginoon dahil mahal mo ang kapatiran. So, is there a hindrance in fellowship with them, fellowshipping with them? May mga nagahadlang ba? Dapat po alisin na natin yun. Kung mayroon pa rin bitterness, sabi nga, replace it with your love in my heart. Can we really say from the bottom of our heart that I am a Christian? Kaya po ba nating sabihin? And can we really say how and why we are a Christian? Ayan po, sinabi ni John dito kung paano natin mapapakita na talagang tunay na Kristiyano. Do we really obey and walk in His word? Talaga po bang sinusunod natin? Are we keeping His word and doing His commandments? So it is a challenge for us today so that we can have a true fellowship with God and with the brethren. And God bless. Let's pray. Father in heaven, Lord, thank you once again for reminding us that the true fellowship